Good morning, dear students. Today we are supposed to look after the part 2 of the topic Pila Globus. As in the initial lecture we have discussed about the classification, the natural history, the habitat, and the morphology including the paleal complex. In the today's lecture we are discussing about the digestive system of Pila. The digestive system of Pila comprises of the alimentary canal, the salivary gland, and a large digestive gland. The alimentary canal is distinguished into three regions: the foregut, also known as stomodium, which includes the buccal mass and the esophagus; the midgut or mesenteron, which includes the stomach and the intestine; and the hindgut, which is the proctodium, which includes the rectum. The midgut alone is lined by endoderm, while the other two are lined by ectoderm. The foregut. The foregut includes the mouth, buccal mass, and esophagus. The mouth is a narrow vertical slit which is situated at the end of the snout. There is no true lips, but the pellicate edges serves as the secondary lip of the mouth. The buccal mass. The mouth leads into a large cavity of buccal mass or pharynx, having thick wall with several sets of muscles. The anterior part of the cavity of the buccal mass is vestibule. Behind the vestibule are two hanging rows of buccal mass. The jaws bears a muscle and their anterior edge having the teeth-like projections, which is meant for cutting up the food particles, especially the vegetables, or it may be the vallisneria or the pistia. The buccal mass. The buccal mass of Pila leads into a large cavity of buccal mass, or also known as pharynx, having thick wall with several sets of muscles. Besides the vestibule are two jaws hanging from the roof of the buccal mass. The jaws bears muscles and their anterior edges having teeth-like projections for cutting up the vegetables. The radula. Above and behind the odontophore is a bag-like radula, which is a diverticulum of the buccal cavity. The radula sac has transverse rows of teeth called as odontoblast. Inside the radular sac is a radula, which is characteristic of mollusca. The radula is made up of many transverse rows of horny teeth. Each row has 7 teeth, 2 marginal and 1 lateral tooth, 1 each, and a central or rachidian tooth in the middle. Thus, in the given formula of 2:1:1:2, the radula moves forward and backward on the odontophore for rasping the food particles. This movement of radula are called as chain saw movement. The teeth are made up of chitin, which is reinforced by hardened proteins. They have sharp edge cutting projections, which cuts like a file and rasps vegetable food. The teeth of radula are worn off in front and a new teeth are formed all the time by odontoblast. On the roof of the buccal cavity Above the radula is a pair of grooved buccal mass, which is digestive. The esophagus. The buccal mass leads into a long narrow esophagus. From near the origin of the esophagus arises a pair of round whitish esophageal pouch. They rise by short ducts and lie below the salivary gland. They are prolongations of the esophagus. They probably secrete digestive enzymes. The midgut. The midgut includes the stomach and intestine. The stomach begins on the left side just below the pericardium and runs backward as a blind pouch on the posterior lateral sides of main wall of the visceral mass. This is a rectangular sac of dark red color having a broad U-shaped internal cavity or rose red color. The stomach is differentiated into two chambers, that is the cardiac chamber and the pyloric chamber. The cardiac chamber is rounded and appears and possesses longitudinal folds on the inner surface. The esophagus opens on into it. The pyloric chamber is tubular and has transverse folds on the inner surface. From the pyloric chamber arises a short bag-like cecum, but it has no crystalline style as found in many gastropods. The intestine. From the pyloric chamber arises an intestine which runs along its anterior edge and further along the digestive gland. Beneath the posterior renal chamber, it then turns upward and backwards in the visceral mass, where it forms the two half or three coils between the gonad in front of the digestive gland before joining the rectum. The hindgut region. The rectum or terminal part of the alimentary canal is a thickened walled tube. It enters the mantle cavity and passes down to open by an anus on right of the head. The salivary gland. The two salivary glands lie one on each side of the posterior limit of the buccal mass and partially covers the esophagus. The surface and margins of each gland are greatly cut up, giving its appearance of a somewhat branched type of gland. The ducts of each gland being near its internal anterior corner and immediately enters the muscles of the buccal mass and opens into the buccal cavity. The secretions of salivary gland contain mucus and enzymes which digest the starch from the food. The mucus lubricates the radula and helps it to transport the food. The digestive glands, often referred to as the liver or hepatopancreas of pila, is somewhat triangular plate or cone with one convex outer and more or less flattened inner surfaces. The cone is spirally coiled from the tip inward and downward following the whorls of the shell. The gland is a brownish or to dirty green color and is quite soft when fresh. Two main ducts arise from the main lobe of the digestive gland. These ducts unite just before reaching stomach and opens into by a common aperture. The digestive gland is made up of a number of fine tubules bound together by a connective tissue. These tubules unite with one another to form large tubules which terminate into the two main ducts corresponding to the main lobe of gland. Corresponding to the terminal part of each tubule is glandular, called the alveolus, and the rest of the tubule is ciliated. The alveoli have three kinds of cell. They are secretory, rheabsorptive, and calcareous cells or lime cells. The secretory cells produce a brown liquid containing an enzyme which dissolves cellulose of plants in the stomach, converting it into pulp. The reabsorptive cells produce a proteolytic enzyme. The enzyme brings about the intracellular digestion of food, of the intracellular digestion of cellulose pulp. The calcareous cell stores the phosphate of lime. The food and feeding of pila. The food consists as the aquatic succulent plants like Vallisneria and Pistia, which are cut down by the jaws and the odontophore. Then the radula moves forward and backward, filling the food into smaller particles, exactly like the chainsaw mechanism. Thus, the food is cut up and masticated inside the buccal cavity. The salivary glands pour their secretions by the means of their ducts into the buccal cavity, where it mixes with the food. It helps the digestion of the starch by converting it into sugars. In the stomach, the food is digested by the secretions of digestive glands. Secretion of digestive gland digests various kinds of food, but cellulose is digested inside the resorptive cells only. Thus, both the intracellular digestion and extracellular digestion occurs. The stomach is the site of extracellular digestion. The stomach is the site of extracellular digestion, and the digestive gland is the site of intracellular digestion and absorption. This is the characteristic of mollusca. Absorption of the digested food parts takes place mainly into the intestine. And finally, the undigested food material is passed off in the form of stool through the anus. Thank you.